Hello, good morning one and all. Today I am going to explain a new topic called 4 cross 4 key matrix. Before going to start the programming of 4 cross 4 key matrix, let's discuss the introduction of 4 cross 4 matrix. A keypad is used to input device to read the key pressed by user and process it. 4 cross 4 keypad consists of 4 cross 4 keypad consists of 4 rows and 4 columns are placed between the rows and columns. A key press establishes a connection between corresponding rows and columns. To read the key press, we need to configure the rows as output and columns as input. Yes. Now we'll show how to do the demo of this 4 cross 4 keypad matrix. First of all, before going to start, you have to use Keel Microvision 4. Keel Microvision 4. We have to click on that. You have to double click on that. After this, go to here. Project is there. See here, project is there. Click on project. Go to new vision project. Click on that. It will open one dialog box. We have to give the name of your project. So I will give some WYU, any of the name. Save it. After save, it will open another dialog box. We have to use a setting called LPC2148. You are using a processor called as an LPC2148. This is LPC2148 board, ARM7 LPC2148 evaluation board. Now we have to click here LPC2148. See here, click on that one. OK. In software part, the startup.ss clicked as no, but in hardware part, you have to click startup.ss, project folder as a yes. After this, go to target, click on target. Right click on source group, because to execute the program, so we have to open the project file of the program. So add existing files to group source, you have to click on that one. Here we are doing a 4 cross 4 keypad. Already I have typed that program. This is 4 cross 4 keypad. Click on that one, add that program and close. After adding, just go to source group. Here source group is there, open that. Here 4 cross 4, click on 4 cross 4 keypad. Now before going to show the demo, I will explain about that program. Before going to start, that program, header files, we are using LPC2148 and standard input output dot h. Now here using a void, first function is void lcd. You have to initialize this lcd. You have to initialize the lcd. Next, similarly, void clear display, you have to clear that LCD display. And after that clearing that LCD display, you have to communicate the LCD to get the output from keypad to the LCD. After that, we are writing a void write command. This is void write command, I will explain later. And write data. This is write underscore data. And we have to use another function, void scan and void get and display. And finally, delay and initialize the port. We have to initialize the port. This is the port and you have to initialize to this LCD board. Now, here, listen here. Unsigned long, you have to declare this unsigned long int. This is a 0EE, this is hexadecimal. That ASCII should be converted into 0. This is 0 and this is 1. And similarly up to this 7 is F here. First is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And this is 8 and this is 9. For 10 indicates A, B, C, D, E, F. Row and columns. Totally 4 cross 4 keypad matrix. This indicates this. Now, we are declaring character as row and column. For 4 cross 4 matrix, we are using row and column. And you initialize the temp, you have to declare. And initialize the flag also. And finally, result and temp one is also you have to use. These are the declaration for keypad 4 cross 4 keypad matrix. Now we'll go for logic. See here. We are using a void get key. Void get key this function indicates here. We are using a infinite loop, while loop. So after getting inside that loop, we are using a for loop. This is for row 1. This is for row 1. And this is for row 2. And this is for row 3. And this is for row 4. After using this row 1, this is row 1, row 2, row 3, row 4. And similarly, after this, we have to use column also. Column 1 up to column 4. To accept the values into the LCD. Now, after this, we are using a scan function. In scan function, we are using a temporary variable 2 is initialized to input output pin, and temporary 2 variable is also initialized to another one temporary 2. After that, we are using a AND operation to initialize. This is status of port 1 and verifying the column key. And we are giving the delay for this input output pin. Delay 100 give debounce the delay check again. We have to, it will debounce it. So we have to using delay function. And similarly, we are using the function if temporary variable is not equal to this x of value, because it stores the value into the result. If you want to get the result and it stores the value, so we are using this function again. We have to inside this condition statement, that is, it will verify the row, and finally it scan the value into the result, and it should be stored into the some output function. And finally, we are using a display function, and after displaying this function, this is the display function. That pointer should be while pointer is not equal to slash zero, and this indicates a null, and temporary variable should be, this pointer should be put into the temporary variable 1, and LCD underscore data. We have to collect the data and it should be put it into the LCD display. So it will display the value of the keyboard. Finally, these are the function here. LCD initialize the value. This is for row 1, row 2, row 3 and row 4. After row 1 and column initialization, we will directly will go for the display function. See here. And we also collect the data. These are the functions. Data function. This is LCD underscore data. This function will be include this, and also this is a LCD underscore comma. Com indicates communicate the LCD value. These are the default function. You have to remember this one. After this, finally, we have to clear the display. For clearing, we are using a temporary 1 is equal to 0x1 hexadecimal, and communicate, we are using this function. Already we discussed about communication. We have to include this function and give the delay to execute the program. Now, after this, we have to dump the program into the sum part. After this program, now I will build the program. I will save this program and I have to build the program. See here, zero errors and zero warning. Now we have to create the hex file. Right click on that, open for target 1. Click on that one. Now we have to fix the target. This is target. Click on use microlib and go to output. Click on, we have to creating the hexa file. Don't click on batch file. You have to create hexa file. And after that, finally, we go for linker. In linker, you have to click on use memory layout for target dialog. You have to click on that and OK. After create the target of hexa file, now again, you have to save this and you have to build. See here. It is creating the hexa file. Zero errors and zero warnings. Now, after this, close this file, and that program should be dumped into the hardware part. For dumping that hardware part, we have to use a flash magic. Click on flash magic. Okay. It will open a flash magic software. After this, already in previous experiment, I showed that step 1, step 2, step 3, step 4. These are all the default thing. Just directly browse this function. Browse, and we have to create. This is the function file, and open. Now, finally, step 5 is we have to click on start. It will wait. Just a minute. Browse. Yeah. We take the file name WUV, and start that button, it will processing the value. Now we will check the output of the 4x4 keypad matrix.